Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In our previous two videos, we covered Scan Scazzy tool, Scazzy CMD tool, Tape tool, and Tape tool GUI. In this video, we will continue discussing the other CommVault tape library tools. Please, like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. The next tool to discuss is ArmTool. Do not run the ArmTool while jobs are running on the MediaAgent. Stop all CommVault services that are running on the MediaAgent, and stop and close all of the applications that are using the tape library before you use the ArmTool. The ArmTool provides you with the ability to perform these library tasks to help you analyze and troubleshoot issues with tape libraries. When ready, press Enter to begin. A list of the tape libraries that are connected to the server appears. In our environment, we have one tape library, so the MediaAgent hosts this one IBM tape library. This is the Scazzy address used by this library. When ready, press Enter to continue. This is the list of operations that you can perform on the tape library. Let's select option 1 to display the slot map. Here you see the slot number and the tape that is located in the slot. This is quite handy when you do not have physical tape library GUI access, and you need to know what tapes are in the library, especially during tape handling activity. Press Enter to return to the previous menu. Now let's select number 2 to display the port map. This is the port map. As you see, there are 4 IE ports in the library, and they are empty, which means no tape is exported out of the tape library. Press Enter to return to the previous menu. Let's see if we can find bad barcodes. Select option 3 and press Enter. This is about bad barcodes. There are no bad barcodes found in this tape library. Press Enter to return to the previous menu. To perform any of these tape operations, we must first set up drives. Select option 4 and press Enter. These are the 4 tape drives that are detected in this IBM tape library. As you see, there is not valid against the tape drives, which is related to Scazzy address. To assign the Scazzy address, select the tape drive number. Type 1 for tape drive 1, and hit Enter. Select the Scazzy address you wish to assign to the tape drive 1. Type 1 from the list and hit Enter. You now see the Scazzy address assigned against the tape drive. Repeat the same steps for all the 3 remaining tape drives. All the 4 tape drives are now set up. Type 0 to return to the main menu. Let's try mount a tape in a drive. Select option 5 and press Enter. We first need to select the tape to mount in a drive. Select option 1 to change the source slot. We are selecting slot 1033, which has tape QC0009L4. We now need to select the destination drive. Select option 2 and hit Enter. We will mount the tape in drive 1. Select option 3 to mount the tape and hit Enter. Tape is successfully loaded in drive 1. Let's try if we see the tape mount using CommVault GUI. As this operation is made behind the scene, using command line interface, CommVault is not aware of it. Press Enter to continue. Let's return to main menu and check in the slot map if tape still in slot. Slot 1033 is empty, which means the tape is successfully mounted in tape drive 1. Let's unmount the tape drive. Select option 6 to unmount tape. First option is to select the source drive, so select option 1 and hit enter. The tape is mounted in drive 1, so select option 1 and hit enter. Select option 2 to select the destination slot. Ideally, it is recommended to unmount media to the same slot from where it was picked for the mount operation. But for this video, we will unmount it into a different slot, that is 1043. Type 1043 and hit enter. Select option 3 to perform the unmount operation. Tape media is successfully unmounted from the drive and placed in slot 1043. Press enter to continue. Let's return to the main menu and check in the slot map where the tape is. The tape is indeed unmounted to slot 1043. Let's check in CommVault GUI. We still see the tape in slot 10, whereas it should be seen in slot 20. As discussed before, the operations we are doing are behind the scenes, and CommVault is not aware of those actions instantly. Using this option, you can move tape within the library. If there are any media in the IE slots, you can import them using this option. You can also export the media in the library, the tapes that we saw in the slot map. You can unlock the door of the tape library from here. You can as well lock it. If required, you can run the inventory for the library from here. Select option 12 and hit enter. This option will rescan the library for its contents. Press enter to continue. Rescan or discovery completed successfully. Press enter to return to the previous menu. If required, you can perform the exhaustive detection from here. Do note, exhaustive detection will mount and unmount tape from each drive, and if there is a mismatch in the access path, it will rectify it, but what you need to know is, these are behind the scenes, so CommVault configuration using the GUI is also needs to be changed to successfully access the tape library for operations. Select 0 and press enter to exit from the ARM tool. For the changes made using the command line and for them to be seen in the CommVault GUI, you need to take the library offline and online in the GUI interface. Right-click on the tape library. Select Properties. Library Properties window. Select Status tab. Under Status, uncheck the option Enable Library and click OK. This would make the library offline in GUI. Wait for a minute or two before bringing it online. To bring it back online, repeat the same steps that we used it to make it offline. Library is showing ready. Let's verify the changes we made is now visible or not. We do see the tape is in slot 20 instead of slot 10. The last tool to discuss is Virtual Library tool. We have already discussed this tool in detail in our other video. The Virtual Library tool must only be used to evaluate and test the CommVault software. Do not use the Virtual Library tool for data protection, as it does not store any real data in it. We will end this video here. If you like this video, please do click on the like button. Do subscribe to our channel, if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.